previous video related to this chapter. The chapter name is Shapes and Angles. In the previous video, we have studied about the shapes in which we have learned basic objects like point, line, line segment, rays. After that, we have seen what is shape, in which we have studied types of shape, that is open and closed. Am I right? Yes. Today we are going to study about angles. Okay. So first question, what is angle? Have you heard the word angle? If yes, comment down below. Otherwise, we will learn in this particular video what is angle and what are the different parts of angle. So let's start. What is angle? So the angle is distance between two rays. Have you studied rays? Yes. In the previous video we have seen a ray has one end point and it extends in one direction. So it is a distance between two rays. We have to draw this ray two times, but it meet at a common end point. So we have already seen the ray has only one end point. So if I draw another ray, a second ray like this, these are the two rays, ray 1 and ray 2. Both the rays, ray 1 and ray 2, meet at which end point? That has this common end point, and this common end point is known as vertex. Okay, the common end point is known as vertex, but the distance, this particular distance, if I talk about this particular distance, that is distance between ray 1 and the distance between ray 2, this distance is known as angle. Am I clear? Let's see again. The distance between two rays. Which are the two rays? Ray 1 is the one ray and ray 2 is the another ray. The distance between these two rays are known as angle. And these two rays must meet at a single or a common end point. And such a common point is known as vertex. What is called? Vertex. Am I clear? And another definition for angle is amount of turn between two straight lines or rays. Let's see. Amount of turn between two straight lines or two rays share a common end point. So if I draw one ray like this, let's say ray OP is the one ray. If another ray turns at this particular angle, if I take another ray like this, let's say OQ, ray OQ. So the turn taken by the ray is, this turn is known as angle. These are the two common definitions of the angle, which you will find in the various text. Okay, the first definition is the distance between two rays, and another definition is the amount of turn between two rays. Okay, and the common end point, you have to remember this. All angles have common end point, and this common point is known as vertex. Here also, the point O is known as vertex. Is it clear? Are you clear with the definition of angle? If someone asks what is angle, you can define in both ways. Am I clear to you? Very good. Okay, from this we can simply say that angle is a figure formed by two rays. It is a figure formed by two rays with a common point. Again, what is angle? It is a figure formed by how many rays? Two rays with with a common end point, and such an end point is known as vertex. Am I clear to you? Okay, once again, what is angle? It is a figure formed by two rays with a common end point. We have studied end point. Okay, so I hope you are clear with what is angle. So till now we have studied about the angles. So let's take few examples. If I draw a ray like this and a ray like this, so the angle is nothing but a distance between these two rays. Am I right? It is the angle. And this common end point, this common end point is known as vertex. Very good. This common point is known as vertex. Let's take another example. If I draw a ray like this with a common end point and another ray like this, so this is nothing but an angle. Am I right? This is vertex and this is angles. Let's take another example. If I draw a ray like this and another ray like this, so this particular turn or distance between two rays is nothing but angle, and this common point is vertex. Is it clear, students? As we all know, length can be measured in millimeter, centimeter and meter. So these are, that is centimeter, millimeter and meter are the unit for length. Same way we can measure a weight in grams, kilograms and tons. In the same manner, for angle, we can say that it is 45 degree. What is the unit for angle? Unit for angle is degree. What is the unit for angle? The unit for angle is degree, and we can denote it by symbol this. For example, here what I have written, 45 degree. So you can read this particular dot is nothing but a symbol of degree. We can say that it is nothing but 45 degree. Is it clear? Here it is 90 degree angle. Okay, here it is 130 degree angle. Is it clear? What is the measurement for an angle? We can measure angle in degrees. The unit for angle is degrees. Is it clear now? The next important topic is parts of an angle. Okay, so what are the parts? You already know, but let's discuss in detail. First part is arms. So what are arms? Arms is nothing but the rays that form an angle. The angle formed by how many rays? Two rays. So the rays that form an angle are called arms or side of the angle. Let's see. If I draw a ray like this and a ray like this, so these both rays are nothing but arms of an angle. These both rays are nothing but arms of an angle. Let's give them a name. Let's say this ray is OA and let's say this ray is OB. So OA and OB are the arms or sides of an angle. Now the second part is vertex. We have already seen what is vertex. It is the common point where both arms meet. As you can see here, the arms OA and the arms OB both are meet at this common point. So we have already learned this point is nothing but vertex. Is it clear? The point where both arms meet, such a common point or end point is called vertex. And the rays by which angle is formed, the rays by which angle is formed, these rays are called arms or sides of the angle. Is it clear now? Here we can say that O, point O is vertex, and OA and OB are nothing but arms. OA and OB are arms. And we have seen we can measure an angle using which unit? Degree. But how to denote angle? As you can see here, the angle is made by two rays, that is ray OA and ray OB. So how to denote an angle? We can denote an angle using this sign. This is nothing but a sign of an angle. Is it clear? So in our case, the angle is nothing but angle AOB. Angle AO and B. Is it clear? Always remember, the middle letter always show the vertex. Always show vertex. In an angle, the middle letter always show vertex. We can denote any angle using this sign. In our case, the angle was A, O and B. I hope you will clear with the concept of angle and parts of angle. Okay. Now, let's discuss the example of angles. In our day-to-day life, we came across many objects which has angles. For example, this whiteboard. This whiteboard has four angles. Can anyone notice that? Yes. These four corners are nothing but angles. If I draw a ray here and a ray here, so the angle made by these two rays are nothing but 90 degrees. Same way here, if I draw a ray here and a ray here, so the angle is a distance between these two rays. So here also the angle will be 90 degrees. How to measure angle, we will discuss in further lecture. For now, remember this example. Let's take another example. If you have seen a rooftop, if this is a house, this is a house, so the roof makes angle. If we consider this as a ray and this is also a ray, so the distance between these two rays is nothing but angle. Let's take another example. If I draw a clock, my drawing is very good, you can see that. In our case, we have made a 1 minute hand and 1 hour hand. Okay, so the distance between these two hand is nothing but angle. It can be 90 degree, it can be more than 90 degree. In any case, the distance between these two hands denote angle. Let's take another example. If my fingers are like this, so these two finger has angle of this many. These two angle made angle like this. These two angle make angle like this. Even my elbow. A1, if I put like this, so this is a angle, the angle between my arms and my shoulder, the which has a common end point such as elbow, which we know what we call that common point, vertex. So the angle is this between my arms and between shoulder. This represent rays. So these are the example of angles. I hope you can find n number of example, many example around you. So the activity 2 for this chapter is find at least 3 more example related to angles. Okay, thank you.